So this last bit of code with the legend, we've put our circles in. Now we want to append text. For the text SVG, instead of CY, it's simply Y. There's no center to the text. Instead of CX, it's simply X, since we only need to specify the Y and the X of where we want to draw the text. In here, while it may seem somewhat arbitrary, we've actually drawn the text at the same position, I times 30, as each of the circles, but this is actually going to draw the text slightly higher, since it's going to draw the bottom of the text at position I 30, and we actually want the center of our text to be in line with the center of our circle. So in our case, the default text is 10 pixels tall, so half of 10 is 5, and this will position it perfectly in line with the circle. And for the radius, what might seem arbitrary of 5, we've simply drawn it 5 radii over from the circle itself. And again, for these values, they might seem hard-coded here. We can simply experiment and change them up or down to achieve a different effect. And once we visually are happy, we can set them in our code or abstract them into variables higher up. The last bit here simply changes the text attribute of the text SVG element. And since we've bound strings as data, D in this case is simply a string, either home team or others, and we can just return the datum itself without any further transformation. Saving our file, let's go back to the browser. And voila, we now have proper labels, home team and others, so that our readers know which the red circles represent, what the blue circles represent, and can draw their own conclusions given the information we've presented them. While we may have seen red circles early on being much higher attended, every reader might interpret this chart and find something different and new depending on where they're coming from, what their pre-existing biases are, and what relation they might have to the data.